You're listening to the Podcast Detroit Network. Visit www.podcastdetroit.com for more information. The views and opinions expressed on this show do not necessarily represent those of the network, its advertisers, owners, or sponsors.
Travel, beauty, fashion, entertainment, arts, fitness, celebrity interviews, and inspiring, engaging conversations with some of the best new and old music around. All this and more when you tune into On The Go with Tiffany Patton Podcast. Now, here's your host, Tiffany Patton.
Good afternoon. You're listening to On The Go with Tiffany Patton, your link to love, life, and liberty. And I have an amazing show for you guys today. It is Women's History Month, and all month long, I've had some really phenomenal, dynamic women here live in the studio with me. And today, I'm continuing that run, because there's so many dynamic women in the world out here who are doing amazing things, and you need to know about them. They are literally making history daily, on a daily basis. And I am so excited because I have no other than many artists that are going to be a part of this weekend's Black Women Rock event here in the Detroit metropolitan area at the Charles H. Wright Museum. And I have no other than Idea, Mahogany Jones, Jessica Caremore, so many. I mean, and there's so many more. I'm going to introduce you to some women who are just fire acoustically and otherwise. And so I'm very excited to have them on the show, along with just a dynamic woman. She is a minister. However, she's also an author, and she has a new book out called Glambitious. And we'll be speaking to her about that book. It's no other than Tara Hodges, Tara Carissa, because she goes by Tara Carissa because she is no longer that last name. And so I'm so excited to have her here in the studio with us talking about her new book. And then, of course, I have no other than a lot of times we think about the beginning of the year, and it's the third month now, and we think about all of the things that we want to change. And we think about getting physically fit a lot of times. However, we rarely think about getting fit in our finances and our credit. And so I have someone who is going to be talking to us about how we can get our credit intact. And I'm so excited to have Sabrina A. Smith. She'll be talking to us about credit wellness and what we can do and how she can help you get your credit intact. And that's what we want to do. And then, of course, I have just a plethora of other women who will be joining me on today to just tell how dynamic they are, what they do, and why you need to step out on faith. I always like to start off with something encouraging. And today, I just want people to step out on faith. A lot of times we hold back because of what we see and hear. But I want to challenge you to do it even if you're afraid. A lot of times we don't talk about, you know, fear, because you shouldn't have fear. Fear and faith can't reside in the same place. However, there is a certain fear that's actually good for you, because that's what will allow you to prepare you, propel you into the area in which you need to go. There is that type of fear. It's not something that stifles you. It actually helps you and pushes you into your destiny. And so I want you to utilize that. You know, don't think about fear of failure. Use your faith and just say, you know what? I'm not going to fail. Even if it doesn't work out the first time the way I do it, you won't fail the second or the third time you do it. This is definitely the year to step out in faith in all things. That's what you want to do. You want to make sure that you do that, because there's so many things and so many people that are waiting on you. So make sure that you Be the very best you and invest in yourself. So many times we invest in other things and other people, and we forget to invest in oneself. And once you invest in yourself, you'll learn that there are other things and other people who need exactly what it is that you have. But you'll never know what you have if you don't invest in yourself. And the more you invest in yourself, if you don't have faith in yourself, you'll begin to have faith and confidence in yourself. So start with you. Have faith. Do it afraid, even if you think that you can't do it. Continue to press on and be exactly, unapologetically, who God created you to be, because he doesn't make mistakes. Okay? So have faith on today and rock it out. Do something this weekend that you would never have done if you didn't have faith. Do the thing that you've been fearful of doing, and do that thing. That is the thing that I want you to do. That is the word of the day. And I want to do this too. Okay, so Facebook Live, there's a shirt that I have on, and it's repping Detroit, just really, really strong. And I love this shirt, and it is a new it's a new line by someone here in the Detroit metropolitan area that I really want you guys to follow. And the name of the clothing line is FIP Clothing. They have the dopest shirts, and I'll be rocking them and repping them. So you want to make sure that you do that. Check them out. Look them up. If you have love for the D, you definitely want to make sure that you, and they just don't have those types of shirts, but I love Detroit. I love my hometown. I wrap them everywhere I go. So you definitely want to check them out. FIP Clothing, they're on Instagram. So follow them. You can see their shirts, pretty dope. And talking about dope, I told you guys I have some really phenomenal women that are on my show today. And I'm so excited because I have someone that is like a big little sister who is absolutely phenomenal. And she is an author. And a phenomenal writer. Not only is she that, she's a minister of the word. She's a prophet of God and a prophetess of God. And I know she, doesn't want me to kind of go on and on and on, but she's a phenomenal woman and she lives her life unapologetically. And this woman has a new book called Glambitious. And I'm so excited to have her here. No other than Tara Carissa. Hello, ma'am. How are you?
Hey, woman of God, I am blessed. Thank you so very much for having me. To God be the glory.
Yes, ma'am. I'm telling you. Okay, so it was so funny. So I'm driving and I'm with my daughter and I'm talking about the book. And I'm talking about the name of the book. And as soon as I said the name, she was like, oh, that's dope. I really like it. I really like it. I said, yeah. She said, you know what? And that suits her. I said, wow. And to think that, you know, you think the youth aren't paying attention, but they are. So Glambitious. Mm-hmm. Tell us about that book and a little bit about what drew you to this project.
Awesome. So a little bit about the book, Glambitious. That's a combination of glam and ambition, so mm-hmm. glamorous and ambition. And every book that is really a compilation effort amongst myself and about 20 other women where we really come together and we tell our stories. And I think that is so important that women across the globe understand that we all share similar stories. We've mm-hmm. all had ups and downs. We've all had hurdles and obstacles that we've all had to overcome. And when people come together and get transparent and tell their story in an empowering way, not just, oh, I went through, but I came out and I dominated and I'm winning and I'm walking in my victory. That's what you call ministry. And so mm-hmm. I'm blessed and honored and humbled to be a part of that. And I'm just excited. And I want anyone who's listening in right now, if it's you as a woman, if it's you listening in on behalf of your mom, your wife, your daughter, please definitely check out the book Glambitious, because I'm telling you, it is a book filled of women who have survived, and they're not just surviving, but they're thriving.
Yes. Now, you know, so many times us as women, we're quiet or we become silent. And we think that a lot of the things that we went through, we see it as an embarrassment instead of a testimony, which is what it truly is to other people. And so we keep some of the things and our experiences and the things that we've gone through or go through, we keep it to ourselves, not knowing literally that that is a book within us, that those are words that can literally set other people free and encourage and empower other women. What do you say to the woman who, has, you know, who keeps her mouth closed, who doesn't speak out? What do you say to that woman?
You know what? I would have to say that your testimony is only embarrassing to the enemy, because the enemy is literally looking at your life saying, oh my God, I did all of that to her. I put her through all of that. And she's still moving. She's still praying. She's still testifying. She's still singing. She's still worshiping. She's still fasting. Mm-hmm. And so, yes, your testimony, what you've been through, it is embarrassing, but not for you, but for the enemy.
Yes.
And so I would say, to shift her perspective and understand it. There's nothing shameful that you've been through, even if you did make bad decisions. Join the club called humanity. There's not a person walking in the face of this globe that has not made a bad decision. You know, one of the things that I really admire about our former president, President Obama, mm-hmm. is that he told his story before anybody else could tell it.
That's right.
And in his book, The Audacity of Hope, he talked about smoking marijuana and just things that maybe if the press had found out before he put it out there himself, mm-hmm. it could have been a scandal. But because he owned his story, I tell people, honey, you cannot embarrass me over my story because I know all the details you think you know and the details I know you don't know. So it's about owning your story. And yes. when you own your story cannot own you.
Wow. That is powerful in and of itself. And that right there, and I tell people all the time, you know what? I can tell on me quicker than you can tell on me. And the reason why I do that is just so the enemy doesn't have anything that he can try to use against me. So many times.
Absolutely.
You know, I think so many times too that a lot of times we think, if we're in Christ or if we're in God or if we believe in God, that things shouldn't happen to us. I don't know where we get that from, because it normally puts a bullseye on our chest, unknowingly. But a lot of times people think, well, why am I going through this? You know, I'm praying, I'm fasting. Like you said, I love God. I'm going to church. I'm tithing. However, I'm still going through. This shouldn't happen. But I don't think, talk to us about the process, because I think a lot of people don't understand what the process is really doing.
Well, absolutely. Well, the Bible says that many are the afflictions of the righteous. So if you are saved, you are going to have problems. And let's just tell the truth. Even before you got saved, you had problems. That's really what drew many people to salvation, was all the drama that was going on in their life.
So yes.
drama is part of the human experience, but it's a part of the human experience not to torment us, mm-hmm. but to develop us. Someone needs to write that down as drama is development. Drama is development. Because when you begin to understand that everything that you have been through has occurred, has happened to teach you, to grow you up, to process you, to groom you, mm-hmm. to mature you, then you begin to look at your process a lot differently. What gets a lot of people down is they are comparing their process to somebody else's promise.
That's right.
But you cannot compare your process to someone else's promise because you don't know what their process was. Okay? And so you have to become content with your journey, your lane, your process, and understand that all things work together for the good of them who love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. If Jesus had to go through, if Jesus had to be betrayed, if Jesus had to be lied on, if mm-hmm. Jesus had to be rejected, you're going to have to go through that as well. And it's okay, because Jesus also shows us that not only do you go through, you also come through.
Now, this book, Glambitious, Ambitious and Glamour.
Mm-hmm.
You talk about there's a few key points that we talk about that is presented in the book. The process, the win, the doubt, and the beginning. And a lot of times people forsake the beginning of a thing. And it's so funny because when I was reading your chapter, you talked about, you know, you were doing what you were doing, and you were literally getting blown up without even really unknowingly to yourself, I think, when you started out, that you were being received so well. But that was your start and that was your beginning. And so in my mind, I can almost anticipate that there were things that were going on or that may have happened that could have discouraged you in the beginning to where you didn't complete it or that you didn't continue. And had you not continued, then you wouldn't have started to receive all of the different bookings for to come speak. Like you said on Twitter, it just kind of blew up for you without you knowing. How many mm-hmm. times have you talked to women who have wanted to give up in the beginning? You've talked to them and they said, yeah, well, I started this, but you know what? It just wasn't working out. Oh, okay. So how long have you been doing it? Oh, well, you know, I tried it a month or two and it didn't work. So I don't think I'm called to it, or maybe I shouldn't be doing this. Please.
Well, you know what? I'm going to be honest with you. If you feel like giving up, you're probably not called to it.
Mm.
Because when you have a call on your life, mm-hmm. even when you want to give up, you can't give up. And
that's
we
good.
See that with the book of Jonah.
Mm.
Okay? Jonah wanted to throw in the towel, but he couldn't. God made him stay in his call. I tell people, I've never met a real prophet that wanted to be a prophet.
Mm, I know that's right.
Because we understand the cost that comes with the call.
Mm-hmm.
And so, yes, you feel like giving up, but you don't, because the call on your life is greater than the affliction that the enemy is trying to throw at you. And even on the days that I said, you know what, forget this, I can go back in the world and make my six figures there, destiny was still calling me. There was still a word I wanted to share. There was still a word I wanted to give somebody. There was still an encouragement that I just couldn't keep to myself. It was like fire shut up in my bones, as the Bible says. And so what I would say is, if you genuinely feel like quitting and you can genuinely walk away, you're probably not called to it to begin with.
Hmm.
Because when it's your assignment, when it's your call, when it's your destiny, when it's your purpose, even when you feel like walking away, you don't.
Hmm. That's good. That's good. What do you want women to take away from this book, from you and the words that you wrote? What is it that you want them to take
what
away?
Them to keep moving. Keep moving when you're misunderstood. Keep moving when you're lied on. Keep moving when you're rejected. Keep moving when you're betrayed. Keep moving when people are throwing roadblocks and obstacles in your way because they're jealous. Keep moving. And don't just keep moving. But girl, look good while you move. And I tell people that don't take a lot of money to look good. You can go to Walmart, get a dress off the rack, take it to your local alterations lady, have her break it down and step out looking like a million bucks.
Mm.
But continue in your process. Do not give up. And then another thing is, you cannot take attacks personally.
Mm-hmm.
Even though it's people coming against you, it's not the people coming against you as much as it's the spirit on the inside of them. So you have to pray for the people, but keep it moving and not become discouraged and say, well, I can't believe that my cousin would be that way towards me. I can't mm-hmm. believe that my sister or my aunt would be that way towards me. Well, you know what? I can, because it's not them. It's the spirit that dwells on the inside of them. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood. And if somebody is allowing that spirit to live in them, you definitely need to pray for them, because that spirit is nobody's friend.
Hmm.
If that spirit is using them to antagonize you, what in the world do you think that spirit is doing to them?
That's
They're
true.
Miserable.
Yeah.
That's why misery loves company.
Hmm.
So it's staying the course, not giving up, and looking good while you go.
I love it. I love it. Okay, so how can we get this book? How can we purchase this book? And if, let's say, someone wanted to reach out to you personally to get an autographed copy, how would one do so?
Great. Please go to my website, Tara, T-E-R-A, Carissa, C-A-R-I-S-S-A.com, and click on product. Glambitious is right there. Of course, once you go to my website, there's a contact me page there. You can fill that out and someone on my team will get back with you within 24 hours.
Mm-hmm.
So again, everything is on my website, Tara, T-E-R-A, Clarissa, C-A-R-I-S-S-A.com.
Thank you so much, Tara. I know that you're very, very busy, but you do a lot of things on social media as well. Talk to the people about some of the places they can find you, some of your Facebook Lives possibly, and you do a lot of teachings as well throughout the week. How can we find you to be able to get a hold of you and listen to some of the teachings and watch you on Facebook Live?
Absolutely. So once you get to my website, all of my social media links are there.
Okay.
And that will navigate you to my Facebook page, my Instagram page. And at least 3 times a week, I do a live teaching that people from all over the globe call into. And of course, that's on my Instagram page. So once again, just get to my website, Tara, T-E-R-A, Carissa, C-A-R-I-S-S-A.com. And all of my social media links are there. So thank you so very much for having me. To God be the glory. I'm truly honored, truly humbled, and I really want the women of God to be encouraged. So I am excited. As a matter of fact, everyone who orders from listening in today, again, Tara, T-E-R-A, Carissa, C-A-R-I-S-S-A.com. Click on products for the book, Glambitious. It's an ebook. You can download it and begin reading it tonight. Everyone who orders because they listen in, I will send them a bonus recording, How to Prosper from Your Pain. And that all is right. Literally a step-by-step guide on how to make 6 figures from all the hell that you've been through. I tell the women and the men who follow my ministry, if you're going to go through hell, you're going to make hell pay you. And the biblical example of that is when the children of Israel got ready to depart Egypt, they plundered the Egyptians. So you're not going to put me in hell and think I'm not going to charge you on my way out. So
all right.
There is prosperity that awaits you. So everyone who is getting the book, because they listen in, again, Tara, T-E-R-A, Carissa, C-A-R-I-S-S-A.com. Click on products and Glambitious will download immediately. Your bonus gift will go out tonight.
All right. Love it. Okay. So you guys have heard it from her personally. She stated that when you purchase the book from her website, because you've heard this broadcast, you will also receive a free teaching, something that you definitely want. I mean, so many people are trying to prosper in the wrong way. She has teachings to help you get it the right way. And like she said, out of her mouth, if you're going to go through hell, you might as well allow yourself to get paid for it. And that is a biblical sense. We're not cursing. We're not, you know, going, being outside of biblical times. She's even give biblical scripture behind it. You might as well. Don't allow everything that you've gone through to just be in vain. There are things and spoils that you need to get, not only your stuff, but you can get the spoils of other people's things if you would just set your face like a flint, and then get the teachings and things that you need to be able to do so. And Tara Carissa has multiple things, but if you're listening today, she's also giving you a free bonus, so you definitely want to make sure that you take that into consideration. Go click on download, get the book, and then get your free nugget of how to prosper and be blessed, because this woman of God is certainly blessed beyond measure. Tara, I thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy schedule to be on the go with us today. And congratulations on your latest project, Glambitious, because you definitely look good. Every time I see you, you look good doing what you do.
Well, thank you, honey bunny. I appreciate that. Thank you so very much. And thanks for having me. Have a great day.
You too. That was Tara Carissa. Bye-bye. She is author and a minister, just a powerful woman of God who is doing great things, not only in the Atlanta area, but in and around the world. She has a new book. She's a part of a new project called Glambitious, and she is certainly that. She is beyond ambitious, but she looks good while she does what she does. Go ahead, click on her website. Go to her website, download the book, and then when you do that, she's also going to give you a bonus just for hearing it here on the Go. This is On the Go with Tiffany Patton. You're linked to Love, Life, and Liberty. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back.
You are listening to On the Go with Tiffany Patton. You're linked to Love, Life, and Liberty. So trust God today, okay? That is the word of the day. We have Grammy Award winning international jazz saxophonist, Najee, speaking with us.
This is something I would have done for free. You know, well beyond what I could have ever imagined as a young kid. You know?
Yeah.
It's a different time now. Mm-hmm. It's just a different climate. Honestly, I would say that even though it's a different time, there are new opportunities available.
Mm-hmm. Not just about ourselves and not just about getting houses, cars, or increasing money. But honestly, the state of our nation and where we are, other people, other families, and our youth and these children.
You are listening to On the Go with Tiffany Patton. Y'all keep it live.
I
I don't even want to say that I'm starstruck because I normally don't get starstruck.
You are listening to On the Go with Tiffany Patton, your link to love, life, and liberty.
I'm on the go with the very beautiful Kathy Hughes.
Unfortunately, a lot of women don't open the door for other women, which is so bad. Radio has instant gratification. You can help people with the sound of your voice immediately and to be able to connect people. So don't ever, ever, ever look that back. Don't ever doubt yourself and just know that when the time is right, the good Lord will send the blessing.
Grill, located inside the Western Book Cadillac Hotel in Detroit, presents a casual approach to fine dining and the best ambiance in the city. Come witness it for yourself. For more information, call 313-964-3821 or visit the website at 24grill.com.
Hey, is your business in constant need of graphic design? L. Ross Designs provides quality flyers, Snapchat filters, logos, business cards, and any of your day-to-day design needs. 3 monthly package options available, or just order single projects as needed. Visit us today on the web at www.lrossdesigns.com.
back. That was Cece Pennison. We got a love thing, and we have love for her here in the Detroit metropolitan area. It is going down this weekend. She is a part of Black Women's Rock event this weekend, and I have so many of the talented artists that are going to be hitting the stage this Saturday, live in the studio with us, and in just about a few minutes. So I am so excited to have them here, because these sisters are telling you, you haven't heard music until you've heard them do what they do so well. And definitely a shout out to Cece Pennison. She will be here live in the D, doing what she does best. And if you haven't seen her live, oh my goodness, she literally brings it. Okay. So you are definitely in for a treat, her plus many other women this weekend. And talking about being on the go in and around the city of Detroit, there are so many different things that you need to be aware of that are going on in and around the community. And one of the things that are going on, a lot of times we forget about our seniors. A lot of times we don't think about those who have, you know, become grandparents or our mothers and our fathers. And we think that, you know, oh, they're okay. Well, there are a lot of different things that they face that need to be addressed. And I'm so glad to know that there is someone that is definitely taking their issues into consideration, like our councilwoman, Brenda Jones. She is having Livable Communities Community Conversation for Seniors. She is the president of the city council, and it's her along with AARP. They will be hosting an event this upcoming April 11th, and it's from 2 to 4. It's going to be held at the Delray Community Center, 420 Lay Street in Detroit. The zip code is 48209. Free parking, light refreshments will be served, compliments of AARP in Michigan. And you definitely want to make sure that you avail yourselves. If you have a mom or dad that are getting elderly, or grandparents that are getting elderly, and you're concerned about a lot of the things that affect them, this is the place to be if you are in the Detroit metropolitan area. So make sure that you are available April 11th for this event from 2 to 4 p.m. at the Delray Community Center, 420 Lay Street in Detroit. And as I stated, today is Thursday, and we don't want to just get our physical fit on. We want to get our financial fitness and our wellness together. And how we get to do that is, one, definitely taking more concern and a greater or more fine-tuned look at our credit, because our credit matters. It does. And if you say, well, you know what, I need some help in doing that, I have just the woman for you. It is no other than Sabrina A. Smith. She is in the building. Hello, Sabrina. How are you?
Hello, hello, hello. How are you today?
I am wonderful. I am wonderful. I'm so glad, because when you sent me the information, I see you on Instagram doing your thing. I said, you know what? This is information that the world needs to see. It's not just something that affects one person. This affects everybody, from the young to the oldest. All of us need to make sure that our credit is intact.
Absolutely, absolutely. I am so happy and elated to be on today. I do want to share with people, like you said, how important it is to take care of our credit, from the youngest to the oldest.
Yes.
And so I've been doing great in this business. I've been in the business for about 2 years now.
Okay.
And so even as I delved into it, I learned a lot of credit tips as it relates to how to keep our credit score up and what makes it drop below. So
okay.
I'm elated to be on your show today.
Well, okay. So you, ma'am, help others with a lot of different services, from credit restoration to credit building, credit attorney, smart credit, discount shopping, LifeLock, financial lockbox, life insurance. Now you got to explain the financial lockbox. But you help people with judgments, those who have tax liens, late payments, repossessions, bankruptcies. It doesn't matter what they've experienced. You're able to assist them and get them back on the right track.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Our services of all that you just named, mm-hmm. it's called the protection plan.
Okay.
And the protection plan includes everything you just named. Our prize service, of course, is the credit restoration. But under the protection plan, you get 12 to 13 different services of all that you just named.
Okay.
Credit restoration, of course, we remove all derogatory items off your credit report.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I found that a lot of people, even young people, they've been victims of identity theft,
yes.
but it's by their own members of a family.
Oh,
you
wow.
know, mom or dad, whoever used their social security number,
mm-hmm.
got a car, got a light bill or whatever it
mm-hmm.
is, and, you know, just damaged their credit.
Wow.
So we get a lot of things off their credit report.
Okay.
And what a financial lockbox is, that's when you have passwords, you know, if a loved one died,
oh, wow,
and
yeah.
say, for instance, a mom or a dad, they don't have the personal information
yes.
concerning getting the passcodes to ATM cards, to banking information. You need that information so you can have access to it.
Yes.
So that's what Financial Lockbox will allow the loved one to have access to the personal information that's allotted to them.
Okay, you know what? That's actually very smart. I'm not sure who thought of that, but that is actually a great thing to have. A financial lockbox. Okay, so is that kind of like a P.O. box that people can go and actually, you know, have a key to be able to get into that the actual individual person has to give over to someone else? Or is that something that is more like a password that can be accessed online?
It could be accessed online. It's a
okay.
virtual lockbox.
Okay.
It could be accessed online. They give their loved one, their loved ones, or whoever they trust, the personal information.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, for instance, if someone died, or if there's a flood, or if there's some sort of fire,
mm-hmm.
you have access to your personal information, to where you're not left, left as a victim or whatever. So we offer this service to loved ones and to, you know, family, so they can have that security.
Right.
In case, you know, something happens with a loved one, they will have access to that information for them.
Okay. Okay. So
yeah.
tell us how a lot of people think that, you know, I've signed up for credit restoration to get my credit intact, and they almost mm-hmm. feel like it may be something that's more instant. You know, where I've paid my money and in like 30 days, they're thinking that there's going to be some huge change or alteration in their credit. And in my mind, I'm thinking, well, it didn't take just 30 days for you to get into the position that you're in. So I'm not
exactly.
really sure why you would think that it'll only take 30 days to get you out of the situation that you got yourself in. Tell us a little bit of a more realistic time frame if a person is looking to restore and clean up or build their credit.
Gotcha. That's a great question. I get that all the time, and that is my actual response.
Oh wow!
It didn't take you 30 days to, you know, get into the rut that you're in. Unfortunately,
exactly.
sometimes things happen.
Yeah.
Just like I'm really sympathetic to, you know, divorced moms
mm-hmm.
and divorced dads. They go through things, but realistically, typically, I tell my clients to keep the services between 4 to 6 months.
Okay.
You will start seeing results maybe after 45 to 90 days.
Okay.
According to the Fair Credit Act, creditors do have 30 days to respond.
Okay.
And so we aggressively send letters to the creditors
mm-hmm.
so they can go ahead and remove those derogatory items off their reports. But typically they will see some results within 45 and 90 days.
Okay. So I had someone send me a question, and they wanted me to ask, I think their situation, they said, well, what if it's someone who just had a bankruptcy completed, however, they ended up racking up medical bills due to them being sick and ill in the hospital. How does that work? Because they mm-hmm. were basically saying, well, I don't even know how to come back from that because I had just wiped everything clean, but now I have this.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely. That's a great question. And I have partners that work with me on this, and they've used the services as well.
Okay.
So with the bankruptcy being on someone's report, they, when they feel like they cleaned everything up or like other things up, such as medical bills, depending on how long the medical bills have been on the report, if they're what you want to call it, derogatory, after 30, 60, 90, 100, 120 days past due, if because it affects their score, we will still send the reports to the creditors to have it removed.
Okay. Okay. So, so basically they need to contact someone as soon as possible to see kind of where they are, gauge that, and then be able to find out where they need to go from there.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay. Okay, so tell us how we can get in contact with you. And then prior to that, what is the one thing or one tip that you would like to leave? Because we love Credit Wellness, and so we're definitely going to have you back next week to talk to us more about how to get ourselves back on track credit-wise. So what is one tip that you would give the listeners in getting their credit back on track?
Absolutely. Great question. I would say because of the services that we provide, we also provide financial literacy. I tell all my clients, take advantage of what we share with you concerning financial literacy. For instance, if you get a credit card, you're already cleaning up your report. Your credit score is shooting up, right? So if you get a credit card and your credit limit is $300, don't max it out because that's going to drop your credit score.
Okay.
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 So the way the credit system works is use only 30% of it.
That's a good number.
$30 of it.
Okay.
The next month, pay it off or pay the minimum on what's due. And then just use that systematically for the next 3 to 6 months, and you will see your credit score continue to shoot up instead of going in a decrease. Instead of going in, you know, instead of plunging down.
Okay, so, that's a good tip. So only use 30% of the credit card on a monthly basis and then pay that off. And then the next month, now, are you increasing this as each month goes on, or just the 30, just stick with the 30% for a certain amount of months and then go from there?
Well, what happens is maybe after 3 months, the credit card people, whoever you have a credit card with, they're going to increase your limit.
Okay.
So that's what happens.
All right.
They will increase your limit. And what happens is what the credit system wants to look at is your ability to be disciplined with paying your bill, of course, on time, but also maintaining that credit limit as far as not going over 30%.
Okay. That's good.
Yeah.
That's good.
So and sometimes we go over, but just go ahead and pay it off the next month.
Okay. I love it. I love it. Sabrina, I thank you so much. Tell us, how can we find you? How can we talk to you? If there's someone listening right now, they say, you know what, I need to get my credit taken care of, but I don't know what to do, where to start. She sounds like I need her. How do I get in contact with, how do they get in contact with you?
Awesome. It's a couple of ways. Actually, several ways. One, you call me at my number at 708-738-9048, or you can email me at sascredit@gmail.com.
Okay, so that's,
or you can check me out on Facebook.
Okay. Okay, so what is your name on Facebook?
Sabrina A. Smith.
Okay. So you definitely want to make sure that you contact Sabrina. She can help you get your credit back on track. It doesn't matter what your situation is, be it if you're unmarried, you're single and you are a single parent and your credit needs to be restored, if you're divorced and your credit needs to be restored, even if you don't have credit and you need to build it, she can actually help you with that too. You want to make sure that you contact her. Her telephone number is 708-738-9048, or you can email her at sass SAS for Sabrina A. Smith Credit. So it's sascredit@gmail.com. Definitely check out her website, www.sasconsultingcredit.com. You can find her here next week, same time. I thank you so much, Sabrina, for assisting us, helping us get our credit back on track.
Absolutely. I love it. I want to add value to people's lives and get them back on track. That's my passion.
Well, you're definitely doing that. And I'm so glad that you chose On the Go to help all of our listeners be able to do so. This is a new year, so we need to get ourselves back on track.
Absolutely. Thank you, Tiffany, for having me.
Oh, you're more than welcome. Make sure follow Sabrina A. Smith on Facebook. You definitely want to follow her on Facebook and Instagram if you're looking to get your credit in order, or if you're saying, you know what, hey, that's not my situation. I actually don't have any credit. Well, she can actually help you build your credit as well. And you can do so. Okay. Give her a call. The number 708-738-9048. 708-738-9048, or you can email her at sascredit@gmail.com. This is On the Go with Tiffany Patton, your link to love, life, and liberty. And what we're going to do, go on a quick break, and we'll be back with more. You're listening to On the Go.
You are listening to On the Go with Tiffany Patton, your link to love, life, and liberty. So trust God today, okay? That is the word of the day.
And I'm honored to have a phenomenal woman with us here to celebrate. She is a singer, a dancer, actress, composer, poet, educator, writer, civil rights activist, and the list can go on and on. She needs no introduction. She is affectionately known as the global Renaissance woman, Dr. Maya Angelou. Good afternoon, Dr. Angelou. It is an honor. How are you?
Good afternoon, Mrs. Patton. Mrs. Patton. It's a pleasure to sit here and wonder what on earth are you going to ask me? I'm really looking forward to finding out what I think.
I'm on the go with the very beautiful Kathy Hughes.
Unfortunately, a lot of women don't open the door for other women, which is so bad. Radio has instant gratification. You can help people with the sound of your voice immediately and to be able to connect people. So don't ever, ever, ever look back. Don't ever doubt yourself, and just know that when the time is right, the good Lord will send the blessing.
Grill, located inside the Western Book Cadillac Hotel in Detroit, presents a casual approach to fine dining and the best ambiance in the city. Come witness it for yourself. For more information, call 313-964-3821 or visit the website at 24grill.com.
Hey, is your business in constant need of graphic design? L. Ross Designs provides quality flyers, Snapchat filters, logos, business cards, and any of your day-to-day design needs. 3 monthly package options available, or just order single projects as needed. Visit us today on the web at www.lrossdesigns.com.
Children, dreams, baggage, heart, memories, bullet wounds, stress, OT, future, pocketbook, and temper, up the stinky stairs of the subway station.
Twin boys, twin boys, twin boys, twin boys, twin boys.
Latino, Indian, African. African, any child in America, wearing Yankees jackets, playing tag, double murder, child stealers, watch them running without worry, laughing with the sunset. How can they be so happy in this ghetto? How can they be so happy in this ghetto? Running past the preppy drug dealers, shifting their smooth feet to avoid the green glass. Four legs find the door to an open apartment. This time they made it, unaware of how dangerous their footsteps seem. So close to home, so close to home. Fat girl, 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 fat girl. White V-neck t-shirt, bra too small, stuffed inside tight jeans, ponytail slick back, 40-year-old lipstick and dream catcher eyes. They follow her, the old men and the teenagers. They whistle and yell. They follow her, but she is lost on her own block. She wants to believe she is more beautiful than her block. When she grows up, she wants to be big, big as a house, with brick windows and paper doors. She wants to draw the doorknob orange and let anyone in who'll give her a little. Man said he was gonna make her big. Man said he was gonna make her big. She wants to be big, big as a house. She'll let anyone in, yeah, anyone in who'll give her a little attention. Somebody's mama giving black folks the what you doing uptown stare down. White blonde lady on heroin broke her arm on New Year's Eve, partying with her friends, prostituting on the local playground. Her bones are sleeping inside the elevator. She has a key but doesn't live in my building. I sometimes live in my building and I can never find my keys. She smiles at my family when she can find her teeth. She wants to get high, but he's falling down. She wants to get high, but he's falling down. She wants to get high, but he's falling down. This is a game she plays with herself every night. White blonde lady on heroin is somebody's mama. Brown eyes, gave birth to twins. One is a little fat girl who doesn't know she's already beautiful, so she dyes her hair blonde, snorts, shoots, and smokes herself skinny. She, any child in America, she, any child in America, with 12 hands, praying for a bigger house, anybody but her own body, is somebody's baby, carrying bags of groceries, waiting for someone to notice them. Walking up 158th Street, walking up 158th Street.
Just hold my hand. I know you feel them in my glance. from a universe I am. The creator has a master plan. I see a lot up in the fan. Catch me if you can. Catch me if you can. The creator has a master plan. I see a lot up in the fan. Catch me if you can. Catch me if you can. I'm running fast. I'm living right. How deep the struggle? How real the fight? Spirit's tight, battlefield, I keep them tight. Grew up with queens and some light. Poetry was dynamite. Hey, I'm not every day. I could fly a kite, I could write a poem, I could save a life, I could have it all, I could wear my skin. I know where you've been, but you survive it all. Keep moving and breathing and loving like the wind. The little things blow right off of your skin.
They be my friend, and brother, and girl. I know that they do. They really, really do. And if you really want it, but you're not fucking with me, let me take you to the other side where they get so far to fly, so high free. Come on.
Living in the world of my own invention. In the war with poetry is my only weapon. From a hood with diplomacy is a lonely lesson. Where the church is the drug, the high, the only reverend. My introspection is making the bread leaven. It was written in physical graffiti like it's Led Zeppelin. Too many rappers, the truth of knowledge is bedwetted. I slice next to the bone like it's the red wedding. The cream is thinner than the ice, we're just getting on. Way more corporate than radios that they're playing on. Way beyond sellout. You fell out with your lady, how she wetter than the force of trying to tap it like Savion. Then I'm just end up the FDR. The world is spinning too fast, they need to let me off. The end is near and the curtain is coming down too. Catch me if you can while I'm running circles around you.
Hand clap, right now. Radio, don't turn it down. I love that sound, I love that sound. Breaking through the undercloud. I can fly a kite, I can write a poem, I can save a life, I can have it all. I can wear my skin, I know where you've been. The creator has a master plan.
Catch me if you can. I'm trying to tell you what you want to catch. This Saturday is one of the most phenomenal shows to date here in the Detroit metropolitan area. If you have not heard about it, shame on you. But it's okay, because that's what I'm here for. It's an amazing show. Definitely that you don't want to miss. And I have some amazing women. It's this Saturday. The doors open up at 7 p.m. Black Women Rock. And that was one of our artists that is live on the show. And so I have so many more. And one just walked in the door. I just walked in the door. She is phenomenal. If you don't know who she is, shame on you, but you will when we're done. We've played some of her music and we'll be playing some more. And it is no other than Idea. She's in the building. We have just an amazing woman. Now, let me do this, because I would be wrong if I didn't. Hey, probably. And see, I couldn't even see. And I tried to say I'd be wrong if I didn't introduce her. I couldn't even get it out. Okay. CEO of More Black Press, executive producer of Black Women Rock. It is the one and only Jessica Caremore. Hello, ma'am. How are you?
I am on a coffee.
Oh, well,
and I am so excited. And the band is rehearsing and they are sounding incredible. I'm
okay.
So ready for Black Women Rock. We have sold out this show another year in a row. And I'm on the moon and I'm just ready for this to happen. And you know, to be something really, everything happens how it's supposed to happen. And we sell out the show every year.
Yeah.
And then people go crazy because they're trying to get tickets that don't exist for seats that we don't have. and we get it. But so what we've done is that we are opening up the space on Saturday.
Okay.
We're not turning people away. We're going to have an overflow room for $10, and all the money, 100% of the proceeds, is going to go to the Phoenix Center, which is a homeless center shelter for That's young good. Teens in the city.
That's good.
And they need to raise $5,000.
Okay.
And for 11 young people to have somewhere to sleep for the next 2 months. And so my vow to them was to make that happen. And so we opened up the overflow room just so we can raise money for them. So I'm happy. I'm blessed. Kat Dyson just got in from Italy. We got Tracy Bumworth on bass. We got some great young sisters playing with us this year. Young sister Alexis Lambre on keys. Aaron Alexis on sax. So it's a mix. We got a sister on tuba. Just the musicality of Black Woman Rock is really special. I'm really, I'm just excited. Like, it's not until, the musicians kind of get together and I see everybody that I know that something really beautiful is about to happen. So,
Anytime you are at the head of anything, you are a beautiful spirit. So all you do is just draw like spirits to you. So that is a given. That I understand.
Yeah. Thank you, Tiffany.
I'm really excited for you because what you're doing really and what people don't understand is, unfortunately, right now, culture and the arts is being taken out of so many things. It's being taken out of our schools. We really don't have a lot of places to go in and around the city. But you, ma'am, no matter where you go around the world, like yourself and Mahogany and Idea, you guys keep it live and thriving in so many different facets, from the arts to, literally even how you all present yourselves, just who you are, how you dress, how you express yourself. You make it and allow people, you allow people the information to be able to change who they are. Because so many people try to be cookie cutter versions of other people because it's politically correct. And what you guys say when you go out of your house, and I don't even know if you guys understand that this is what you guys are doing, but when you leave your home,
us women,
I'm sorry, not girls, you women, you black, beautiful women, when you leave your homes, what you are doing is you're showing people how to be unapologetically who they are and whatever that skin is. People try to be versions of themselves that either their parents have placed on them or the world and society have placed on them. But you're like, no. And then you add the arts to it.
It's not the invisible, like we're not invisible. And sometimes, black girls, I remember I'm talking 20 years ago when I was first coming on the scene as a poet and touring, and young girls would come up to me, or now probably, I don't know, older women, would say, how did you get the confidence to grow your hair out and grow your perm out? How'd you get, just to do that? Why do you have the nerve to wear, just small things that are so small that we take for granted, women who walk in their skin and walk in their natural hair and be their natural selves, take for granted. But a lot of our young girls need to see, this show is really about showing that we are the diaspora, what the diaspora looks like, that we rock in many spaces. But, some of us really do love the space of rock and roll, and that I want black girls and black women in general and just all people to understand that this genre of music belongs to us, too. We created the music. It comes from our community. It comes from the blues. It comes from deep south. Even Donna Hendrix in an interview this week said, Mahalia Jackson was rocking. She might have been rocking for the Lord, but
she's still rocking, right?
Listen.
Wow.
So, we're genre, benders. You know what I mean? We're bound. We kick open boxes. Throw away the labels of what everybody is. Some people, we can play jazz, some of this rock and roll, funk, soul, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
But we exist is the point, and that people need to know that these women exist. And I want to, it's not emerging people. These are not emerging. Some of the musicians are younger and are emerging.
Right.
But most of the headliners that I bring for this show on a regular basis are not emerging artists. They are established, independent women who have traveled all over the world. So I need that to be clear, because people think because you don't know them doesn't mean they're not famous.
But see,
there's a difference,
Ideas in the building.
Hey.
And Idea. And when you say not emerging, I think so many times, like you said, just because we don't necessarily see them, we think that they've just started. But they haven't just started. They were kind of on, I almost say, how they say in the Bible, on the backside of the road and the baskets being, okay, yeah, they were on the back road to you, But literally what they were doing, they were ready all along. They were already established.
They were on path, and y'all got to catch up to the starting line.
Yes.
Because there's a lot of other ways to get to something. And so there's other ways and other streams of income and other ways.
Yeah.
Like right now I'm teaching a Black Amarok curriculum at Skyline College in San Francisco. Like, I'm doing that right now. I live in Detroit, and I'm doing that. Like, a Black woman president at a college said, we need to teach this. We need to teach. So I'm teaching joy.
Wow.
I'm teaching Stephanie Christian. I'm teaching Idea. I'm teaching all the women that are going to be in the San Francisco show. They're learning about these women, deconstructing their work, writing responses to it. We deserve to be deconstructed, and people need, and they need it. We need to be inside curriculum.
But yes.
We have to build those spaces, right?
Yes.
And so, yeah, I can't, like, the idea of, like, what's mainstream and what, you know, nobody's trying to blow up. We're longevity artists.
Hmm.
I've been a full-time artist for 25 years.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't going nowhere.
Right.
I'm going to do this till I'm a little lady. Different little, y'all give me some awards. A little, with my little cane. Some of my little home. I'm in my 90s. And I'm going to still have a real young, hot, tall boyfriend. You know what I'm saying? Like,
goals.
All of that.
Right.
Goals.
Goals.
Right.
Goals. That is definitely
yes.
it.
Goals. I'm working on it.
Right.
We're ready, 70-year-old.
All right.
Millennials,
wow.
I'm ready at 90.
Oh my God. Okay, so what have you Idea, what are some of the things that you guys have encountered when it comes to Black women with soul and Black women who actually have the rock component to yourselves in this industry? Have you found it hard? Have you found people very impressed by it and almost like, oh, wow, this is a new flavor, something we've never heard?
I think a lot of times people don't exactly know what to do with it.
Okay.
You know, they don't know where to put us. And
right.
that's why Black Women Rock is important.
Yeah.
Because it's a place for us to go. Like Jess said, I think she said it in her interview. She said, there's not many of us out here, but there's so many of us. You know
what
I'm saying?
That was Sate. Sate said that?
Yes. Okay, yes. Sate said that.
Yeah.
So, yeah. I was just like, yo, like, that's very true. Because being, you know, a Black woman who can sing and can perform, you know, automatically they're going to put us in hip hop and put us in R&B.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And don't let her have a little raspiness to her voice like my own, and then I'm going to be neo soul. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it is, it's like, no, I do electronic music. I do rock. You know, I do some pop stuff. I'm not just, you know, I don't like to be put
in a box.
In a box. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, it's been difficult. But that, again, going back, like, that's why Black Women Rock is important, because it does shine a very necessary light on the women who are doing alternative music out here and killing it.
Right.
Man.
Yes.
Well, you women are killing it. I mean, and all style. And when I talked about style, and then one of the other just alco artists of Black Women Rock, she's in the building. No other than Miss Mahogany Jones. I mean, she brings it all the time. And I think what I love about all of your music individually and collectively is the sound is so organic, but you can hear the culture. You can hear the art. It literally sounds like it's not music. It's literally pieces of art. And I don't know if it's because I'm just a lover of music. I don't know if it's because you're speaking. See, I think us as African Americans, I think when we started, you know, back with hip hop and all of that, we started telling and having a message. And somewhere along the way, we lost the message.
And I think that is what you hear. You know, what you hear is the heart and the intention. You hear purpose in our music.
Yes.
You hear truth in our music. You don't hear, oh, we're out here trying to be cute.
Oh, my God.
Even though we are so cute.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. So fly.
You hear intention. You know, you hear Sojourner Truth. You hear the honesty and the understanding that we've been given this gift for a purpose.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
For sure.
Yeah.
Yes. So, okay. when you guys are in the studio together, so talented, each and every one of you, like, how is it? Is it like an instant party? Like, what's going on? Right. Is it automatic collaboration?
Absolutely.
Does the creative juices just go off the chain? What does that look like?
A party.
It feels like love. It feels like love and a lot of silliness and a lot of ratchetness.
And a lot of righteousness.
Yeah. And the beauty that righteous
an and get over to Eastern Market because some righteousness is going down. The rehearsals are just like, I mean, that's when it starts to feel like, oh, something very special is happening. But it's also like sisterhood.
Yes.
And it's how we have to talk, be honest about, I mean, maybe everyone else, but for me, sisterhood with Black women has been a challenge sometimes for me.
Yeah.
And so I tell the story a lot, but when Nick West, who looks like she could be on the cover of any fashion model magazine, gorgeous, 6 foot tall, could be modeling instead of playing bass.
Yes.
And she said it was the first time she'd been around other Black women, beautiful, confident, independent Black women that liked her. Everyone come, you know, they hate me. And so we come with the opposite of that. Like the reality show that we would put on a Netflix or something would be so different from what you see from Black women on these cable shows fighting over some man.
Come on.
You know, as if. We have those anytime we want. We don't have men. There's no man shortage at Black Women Rock. So we don't do that, and we're not, you know, everybody's a diva, but everybody's taking care of each other. I can't even explain how it feels. It feels so special and fun, and I feel like I'm like a little girl, like, you know, playing with my friends, but something really magnificent at the same time.
You know, one thing I want to say about it is it gives us permission to be all of who we are.
Yeah, and that's
like
good.
This week. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to tell a minor story.
Okay,
so I got a fur coat when I was in Pakistan last winter. Have not broken out the fur coat to wear the fur coat in public. Just like, oh, it's too much. You're just doing the most. It's too much.
Ah.
2 days in a row, I wore the fur coat, and now I'm wearing the sheep. And I'm just like, I'm going to be all of too much because Sunday, all my too much sisters, we got together and we cut all the way up.
That's Man. It. It's freedom.
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
Oh, Black Women Rock weekend feels like freedom.
Yes.
It feels like just pure woman, feminine energy, just loving on each other, just loving our art together, creating more art together, and then also building these lasting relationships that are timeless.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I never thought in a million years that I would be cool with Joy. You know what I'm saying? Like, Joy, like, I grew up and I couldn't listen to her.
Yeah. Right? Hello?
I couldn't listen to her. And now it's like my mama is cool with it. She's like, oh, but...
It's Joy.
It's Joy. I could listen to her.
But you know what? You guys give off that energy. And that's what I love about you all. It just pictures. Honestly, for me, just to be so transparent, I think that's something that Jessica said that is so true. A lot of times it's hard, or it appears to be hard, to have sisterhood with other women because I don't know where that came from. But it's weird because I'm old school. So I come from where, you know, best friends are really best friends, you know, stuff like that. And now in this day and age, it's not that. So you always kind of side eye, kind of looking an extra eye, but I'm genuine. So it's hard to sometimes be free to be who you are because the world seems to like it so much. But you all are so pure in who you are. And I love that every time I see a picture, it empowers me and it inspires me to be even more of who I am unapologetically.
Yeah.
And I've been saying it so much lately, but it's such the truth and I'm not going to cry. But even being in a season where you just truly allow God to strip you of what other people think you are and truly be who you are. That is where I'm
Don't
at.
Have
and I'm
a
telling
senior.
You.
Cut up.
You know, I'm trying to tell you.
That's been the energy, though.
I want to do a little plug because I want to talk about our Sunday because, you know, the way that you're talking, like our Sundays That's our Black on the Rock church. Mm-hmm. And it's from 10 to 3 on Sunday at the Charles H. Wright Museum, and it's absolutely free.
Okay.
And we're doing Reiki and massage and yoga for women from 10:30 to 12:30. You have to just show up and sign up.
Okay.
And Edify is doing Where the Black Woman Go to Grieve, which is an important series that she's been doing with her and P. Maria doing at Sweet Potato Sensations. I've asked her to join us because, you know, people are doing things in different places. It makes sense for us to just do it in the same place. Yeah. It's about healing arts and it works. And so they're going to do that. But the conversation is free at 1 from 1 to 3 with Nona Hendrix. We have our legend coming to Detroit. And I have to just shout Nona Hendrix out because it's important that she say yes. And I've been wanting her to come for many years. And I got my sister, Cece Pennington, coming.
Yeah.
And Jackie Vincent, all the way from Austin, Texas. She's going to be doing South by Southwest and flying into us Saturday morning. And so Sylvia Black, who's an amazing bass player, you know, and Gabby, a guitar Gabby from Atlanta, Georgia, who's a young sister that's got an all-woman band. And so, you know, lots of different energies and different kinds of people coming to join with me and Idea and Mahogany, who represent the Detroit flavor.
Yes.
But it's just important that you hear our stories, because our stories, like the concert's going to be fantastic, and we know this. But Sunday, that talk is so important. And so I'm just really encouraging people to really come out and talk about women who, if you're struggling with being your full self, this will help you get to that place a little bit better on Sunday. These women really have a lot to give, and they bring, and they're giving it. They do this conversation for free. It's not something that's optional in the contract. They don't have to show up, and they do. And then Sunday night, Jackie Vincent, who just fell in love with Detroit when I brought her in January, her band came through and I hosted a Black on the Rock warm-up. She fell in love with PJ Loggerhouse. And so Sunday night, we're having a Black on the Rock rap party.
All right.
Open at 8. If you have a ticket stub, you get in for $5. Me and my
husband. All right.
$5.
Right. Now, you know you're going to spend that on something you don't even really like.
With a ticket stub.
Right.
$10 without one.
So okay.
$10 donation. It's still donation. So Jackie's going to shred all night. And then I just heard that our sister State found out about the jam session Sunday. So she's extending her stay.
Wow.
And she's going to be there, too.
I love
it. So it's about to be on and popping at the house on Sunday night. So I want to encourage everyone to please come out. If you miss the concert Saturday, Sunday night, come jam out with Cat Tyson's going to be in the house. Mm. It's going to be something. So
you know what? You guys.
And all are welcome. Men, white people.
Why you got to say it like that?
Because they don't know.
Sometimes they don't know.
That's true.
You know,
that's true.
They're excluded from this.
Right.
We have lesbians at the show. We have people who are heterosexual. Everyone, bi, tri, trans.
Yeah.
We don't care.
We don't
you identify as girl, you can come. You identify as boy, you can come. Everybody's welcome to the Black on the Rock party.
But you know what? Healing is not a gender thing. Healing, truly, from the inside out, is a everyone thing. Mm-hmm. And I don't believe that you guys really know. Your music really heals people. Mm-hmm. It really is the best form of medicine, because it's a way. A lot of times, if you come at people with a Bible or a scripture or something, they know already to be guarded. Mm-hmm. But with music, it kind of sneaks up on you, and it gets right to the place or the area that you need without you even knowing that you needed it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's the best form of medicine that anybody could ever receive. Mm-hmm. So. It doesn't matter who you are, black, blue, green. Mm-hmm. You definitely want to be at this event, because these women, because of how secure they are within themselves and because they are free within themselves, they're able to free other people.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think you could really free other people unless you yourself is free.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what I think is, too, that's really important. I think being vulnerable enough to administer the truth and be like, these areas, I'm free.
Yep.
These areas, not so much.
That's
but we're working on
it. That's right. That's right.
Yeah. You know,
that's right.
Like to just,
wow.
You know,
I am in the house with just wonderful, wonderful, wonderful black women who are going to rock it out this Saturday. And then Sunday, I didn't even know about Sunday. Okay, so Sunday, it's just more. And you said, Jess, it starts at 11? 10.
It starts at 10.
10 o'clock.
10 a.m.
Okay, so 10 a.m.
Ear candling, yoga in the rotunda. I mean, I brought my sister Violetta on board. We're colleagues
okay.
and a nonprofit that we do some work with youth together.
Yeah.
And she does this healing work. And so she's bringing her healing arts team in there. And so, I mean, I've never seen yoga in the Rotunda, so we're very excited about that. They're doing ear candles, doing massages and Reiki. So just, you know, we want women to feel good. Self-care.
Mm.
And then where do black women go to grieve? It's from 10:30 to 12:30, and an amazing thing that my sister Etta Fly has been doing with her sister P. Marie, so it's just very important work. And then the conversation with Nona Hendricks, CC Pennison, Jackie Vincent, Guitar Gabby, all of us, me, Mahogany Idea, all the headliners, and whoever else want to show up will be there. And we want to pack out that Sunday with young girls, women, corporate women, all women who are just really trying to figure it out and need, they might just need some good words from their sisters. And this is going to be the time to come.
And that's it.
It's all free from 10 to 3.
Okay.
And then that night we're going to party at PJ's Lager House.
Okay.
With Jackie Vincent going to shred the guitar.
I'm telling you.
Like it.
This is the place to be, women. And I just don't want to say women. Those who have young ladies in their homes, please bring them, because a lot of times they're searching. They don't know. They're kind of confused, and they're trying to find who they are. And a lot of times they don't see people who are like them. And it's because they're so creative or because they're so talented, so they don't see it. But they'll be able to come and see more of who they are.
And I want to jump and speak on that,
too. Yes, yes.
I just saw this video of this Asian man who was talking about how he saw Black Panther and how it was so important for him because it was the first time he realized Black women were beautiful.
Wow.
And so when I think about Black women rock and how important it is for not just us to affirm our beauty, but for other people to affirm and see, like, oh my gosh, look at all that raw beauty and look at all that. And I think it's really important too, like you said, so many of us are different and we don't get... We find like there's not a space for us. And I think that that's another amazing thing, too, is it's like, oh, wow, I'm into anime. I'm into this. And, oh, there's a space for me here.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
So I think that that's essential.
Definitely want to come out. I really love the grieving center because so many women, we kind of go through things and blast through stuff and kind of cover up because we as women always have to keep going and always be so strong. And we never allow the true healing to take place because we just keep going. And that's what we do, especially as Black women. We do.
We don't get a day off.
No, we don't. We don't. We just kind of throw the hurt to, you know, throw it to the back. We got to keep going and let's keep it moving.
You got to go to work.
Yeah.
You got to finish up them songs.
That's right.
You got to look cute.
Yes.
You got to work out. Got to drink your water.
Yes.
You
got to take care of the kids.
Got to take care of the kids.
I mean, come on.
We don't get
drink
no water.
Okay.
If I drink another Perrier, another
bone. Divinity just got on here. Hey, Divinity.
Man.
I'm live on Instagram. Hey, Divinity.
We are hello, Kenyatta, Eric, Michael. I'm trying to tell you, March 17th at 7 p.m. Now, it was all sold out. However, the most awesome legendary Jessica Caremore has opened it up. And so it's standing room only. It's like an overflow room. You can come and still be a part of all of the awesomeness that will be on Saturday night. And
just
then
$10 for the overflow room.
Okay.
We have a video projection of the concert happening down there. We have a couple of bars. You can be able to take your drinks down there. Good Cakes and Bakes is vending, so we got some goodies. And we actually got food trucks coming through as early as like 5 o'clock.
Okay,
so,
I did like tacos.
We're going to make it a festival. It's going to be a party.
All right.
Jessica. Is it going to be a taco?
Look at her putting an extra.
I'm not sure what the standard is, but it's a Black woman owned food truck.
Okay. Oh, okay.
That's good enough for me.
Yeah, that's
yeah,
dope.
Whatever she's serving. Yeah.
All right.
I hope we got tacos.
What we are going to do, Jessica, is there anything that you want the listeners to know as far as coming down, as far as getting plugged in, as far as keeping the movement of Black women rock going in a greater way?
Well, I just need women who haven't seen this show to come out. And I need some of my corporate sisters to, like, loosen up the skirts. and the button up.
Yeah.
Now you got to come on out and act like y'all know. Like, you know, and not just wait for the radio to tell you who to come and see.
Right.
Like, you know, because we ain't got no radio support. I've had some urban radio support last year, but this year it was really just WDET and independent resources, like guess, Tell People podcasts and the news. And shout out to the Metro Times who gave us the over the leprechaun. We beat the leprechaun.
Oh,
I mean,
wow.
I'm a
talking
people. The leprechaun.
That's right. That's
right.
It is.
Okay, I'm going to tell all my Irish community
yes.
to come out and support our bar and give $10 for the Phoenix shelter, Phoenix Center, the homeless shelter for teens. You could do some good, get a beer, do some good with your money on St. Patrick's Day.
That's right.
You know, I'm just. And so what I want to say is go to blackamarock.com. We are headlining the Yearbook Run at Performing Arts Center May 12th. In San Francisco. We're going to be the African American Cultural and Arts Center with our talk that same morning, May 12th at 11 a.m.
Okay.
So at an African American ran, woman owned gallery. Our gallery will open, our exhibition will open there. So we're headed to the Bay. So as soon as we're done producing it here, we're working on doing it in California.
Yes.
And then we like to see this all over the world, you know, parts of.
Well, just speak. It's going to be a tour.
Europe,
I mean,
you know,
just,
so it's a global movement, and we're hoping to get some, you know. And if there's black women out there writing checks, feel free to write us one.
That's right. Okay, so yeah,
and black men and all the other colors of the spectrum.
Yeah, this
write
is
checks
true.
And send.
This is true. This is true. Pamela Rogers of Rogers Chevrolet. Yeah. I'm just thinking to call her name out. I mean, she's a black woman who rocks.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, get rock
hey,
on
Pam.
The go. Hey, you know, just. Go ahead. I don't know why that just dropped out of
hey
me,
girl.
But I mean, you never know. Get this tour, Black Women Rock on tour, because it's definitely something that's
we
so
need
needed.
To get it
yes,
on. We need to
yes,
get it,
it
on the road. We need
it
to
is
get in front of these young women, so they are
so
not
they can
having
see.
To search for us so
yes.
so hard. You know, make
yes.
it a little less difficult to get to us and our music. So. And the message is deep. The message
yeah.
is really about the freedom and the independent message about owning your work, about.
Yeah.
making your path or forging your way.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it really, it's about that too. And it's about education. It's about knowing the roots of this music genre mm-hmm. that we're connected to. And so, yeah, so just blackamarock.com, reach out to us. We want to hear from you. We need support. And yeah, we're just, you know, we're just blessed that we're able to do this work. I'm really, really, really excited about this weekend. And I can't wait to do it in year 15.
Yes. Well, when you heal the woman, I think you heal the world, because you know we birth out nations, and your music, Black Women Rock as a whole, just showing the world truly that you have so many facets outside of what is stereotyped upon you is just amazing. So you definitely want to make sure that you go. Get your ticket. You got $10. You can go now.
You can go.
You do be on the overflow, but you can go.
$10 overflow.
And go and just rock it out all weekend long. These women are doing their thing, and they're doing it so fearlessly. I mean, I'm trying to tell you. This is some good music, though, because I kind of took a sneak peek. I don't know. Somebody had posted something of a practice. And I was like, oh, my God, this is just the practice round? Okay.
Oh,
they're
yeah,
playing for real. Yeah, so you definitely want to make sure that you go see it. You got to see the love with the sisters in there. I mean, they literally, they're Facebooking and live each other. This is what sisterhood looks like. If you haven't seen it, it's a beautiful thing. What we're going to do, we're going to go on a quick break, and then we'll be back talking to the women of Black Women Rock. You're listening to On the Go with Tiffany Patton, your link to love, life, and liberty. We'll be right back. Yeah.
How expensive all these pots are, like, and they're like heaven. Like, you could do so much. So, to be here to shoot this, and so we're about to get it in. You guys, it is brick. The forecast is brick. It's so cold, and I just don't appreciate it. New York, Detroit is so cold in a D. It's not supposed to be so cold in New York. Let's get it together. Come on now, let's do better. New York, let's do better. What's really good with the weather?
I don't know.
Stormy today. All of a sudden, that old rain, 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 rain,
want to feel it before I hear it, touch it before I see it. Tell me that I could be it, I believe it since a fetus. Before Michael Jackson beat it with memorize and repeat it. Press rewind on cassettes, you couldn't just delete it. It was a different era back then, back when I was learning to add and subtract all my fractions. Half of what it used to be, but I'm still attracted to the boom back, the way the bass slaps. Before tracks met track, when it was a track, it was my mama's music. I was toothless, used to think that it was useless. Now I use it to groove with, to move with, the ebb and flow, the stop and go, a living life and its movements. Soul music, soundtrack to the power movement. Black that is, let's factor in where it is we end. This where God begins. Let's bring it back. Let's bring it back. Gotta bring it back. Oh, so. Resurrected, resurrected, then perfected. Liquefied, then ejected. In the hearts of the people when they least expected. Give them the sugar water, give them the sugar water. Resurrected, resurrected, then perfected. Liquefied, then ejected. In the hearts of the people when they least expected. Give them the sugar water, they need the sugar water. Community and culture, my Sankofa. When I used to love this and post up all the posters. Before all the poses, when this was like Folgers. The best part of waking up. Let's wake up. This is a shakedown. It's time to take up the grammar. This is my arm and hammer. Time to rebuild and reset the standards. You thinking it's shoots and ladders, but these are serious matters. And say you was the greatest, you had to defend the title. Bring back vinyl, bring back Richie. Not Nicole, but Lionel. When being original was vital for survival. When having a rival wasn't about the image. Wasn't about record sales, wasn't about the gimmicks. We was in it to win it, and to win it didn't mean that we had to mimic. Who was hot for a minute, cooled down by they second round, careers was finished. Then they shine diminished, they just wanna hit it. Ain't nobody committed to making classics. You can feel the difference. We need soul, we need soul. Resurrected, resurrected, then perfected. Liquefied, then ejected. In the hearts of the people when they least expected. Give them the sugar water, give them the sugar water. Resurrected, then perfected. Liquefied, then ejected. In the hearts of the people when they least expected. Give them the sugar water, they need the sugar water. Resurrected, resurrected, then perfected. Liquefied, then ejected. In the hearts of the people when they least expected. Give them the sugar water, give them the sugar water. Resurrected, then perfected. Liquefied, then ejected. In the hearts of the people when they least expected. Give them the sugar water, they need the sugar water.
I'm in love with up, babe. Speed it up and allow me to jump as we heat it up. This art form is something to discover. Come on, let's shoot our album cover. Ooh, touch the boy, babe. Speed it up and allow me to jump as we heat it up. This art form is something to discover. Come on, let's shoot our album cover. First chose me, it was intoxicating, baby. Ooh, to say the least, to some I'm like crazy, but damn it, I feel free. I won't do the explaining, baby. It's just what you do to me.
What you do to me? What you do to me? What you do to me? What you do?
Trying to move on, trying to get grown, trying to move on, trying to move on. Still, I'm holding on. Peace, hear me. Peace, feel me. Give peace to all.
Peace, hear me.
back. You're listening to On the Go with Tiffany Patton. You're linked to Love, Life, and Liberty live here with the women of Black Women Rock. And, okay, so who do I have on the line? Because I've been just listening to some dope music. Is it Sylvia? Hi. Or is it Sate?
This is Sate.
Sate, girl, your music, they were just rocking it out in here, and I'm trying to tell you.
Please guide me. Oh, my God. Guide me. Yes.
Oh, my God. Okay, so.
Hi, Sate. It's Idea. I'm sorry. Hey, girl.
Tell us.
Hey.
Okay, now. And, I'm sorry. I did not know. I'm rocking out to your music so much. We want to make this quick but impactful because we got to get all of you. Okay, so tell us, give us who you are, what you do, and what we can expect on this weekend. Girl, your music is bad. Like, it's just like, I was going to say real. I was going to use a word that wasn't going to be right. So I was going to say gutter, but I didn't mean gutter in a bad way. I meant like it's just like getting down to the soul and scraping it and just releasing it.
Can I quote you on that? Can you send me that? In
oh, yes,
quote?
I will.
I need that.
I will. I will. I sure will. Not a problem. Done deal.
So who am I? My name is Sate, and I'm from Toronto, Canada. Right. Not too far from y'all.
No.
And, you know, what can you expect? Rock and roll.
All right. All right.
Some sweaty, nasty, greasy, gutter. Yeah.
All right.
Hello. Lake spread kind of, you know, that kind of thing.
Okay, is this Sylvia too?
Yeah, this is Sylvia.
Okay, see, you? I didn't know we can do this. And this is good for me. All right. Okay. Hey, ladies, stay in the building. Black Women Rock.
Something.
Okay. Hello, ma'am. You're on the phone. This is Sate. This is yourself. You got Idea. And you have Mahogany Jones.
Yay.
It's a big party
Yay.
Now.
Hi, Sylvia.
Hey, Sylvia.
Ladies.
Hey, Sate.
Hey.
Okay, so.
Hey.
Okay, so, Sate, what instrument do you play?
My voice.
Your voice.
Exactly.
Now, how many octaves can your voice go?
Oh, goodness. I'm working on some more octaves, but I don't know exactly. Maybe 3, 4? I'm not sure.
Wow. Okay. Lord. You know, and then, so Sylvia.
I've never been asked. I've never been asked that.
Oh, wow.
I'm no Mariah Carey.
That's, oh, that's all
that's
right.
That's not what I do.
No, you need to be you, because we need you to be you. It's okay.
Absolutely.
It's
Absolutely.
Okay. So, Sylvia, you play...
Cut out for a second.
I'm sorry. You play...
I play bass, and I sing.
Okay, so a woman bass player. How did that come about? Like, because, you know, you think woman, you think a cello or a violin.
I mean, there's so many bass. Female bass players now. I kind of think it's the thing. It's like, but originally I wanted to play drums, but for Christmas I got one of those tiny practice pads instead of a drum kit that kind of killed it for me. And I said, well, I'm going to find something. And then I said, let's try bass, and I fell in love with it.
Well, I'm so glad that you did, because now we get to enjoy you. We have seen some clips of the rehearsals, and you guys are absolutely amazing. What is it that you want the world who sees you all on this weekend to take away from seeing you do what you do best? Oh, my God. And this is so funny, because then I got Cece Peniston. She actually calling my phone. I don't know how I can do this. Now, this is about to be something really funny. Okay, so hold on. Okay, so Cece, can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Oh, my God. Oh, okay, so.
Wow. We can hear you, too.
Okay, so Cece Peniston and Sate and Sylvia and Mahogany Jones and Idea. In the building.
Yes.
Okay, so what are you guys going to give to us? Because I'm totally floored right
Everything.
Now.
Everything.
Yes. What she said.
Man. Okay, and so, Cece, are you in the DJs yet? Are you coming? You on your way?
I'm getting ready to be there. I'm leaving at 6 a.m. tomorrow, so I'll be on my way soon.
All right. Okay, so...
Yes.
Sylvia, say, how is this for you guys? What was this like, just the energy this week alone?
Oh, I'm not there yet. I'm in Toronto.
Yeah, me either.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
I'm out here. I'm in L.A. right now, so we're flying out.
Oh, so all of you guys
morning.
Are just... Okay, so
yeah.
I don't even want to know what that's going to look like when you guys rehearse tomorrow.
It's going to be crazy.
Oh, I want to be there. I want to see it. Oh, my God. What do you want people to take away from all of you all? I can't even imagine you guys' costumes or outfits that night. I know you're going to be super fly. I already know. And CeCe, you just... I don't even want to ask, because every time you come here, you make an uproar with people. I mean, that's all I hear and see on Facebook.
Girl, thank you so much. I love it, D. I can't wait to come and just to be able to, you know, be involved in Black Women Rock, where all of us come together, you know, the camaraderie and everything. I'm really excited, and I can't wait for tomorrow, because, you know, I get to do a different set tomorrow than I normally do. So,
and that's good.
You know, I'm happy about that. Meet all the ladies.
Man. Okay, so Sylvia and Sate, what is it that you plan to do that's a little bit different? Because I know the world is not used to Black women rocking it out. They're used to us, you know, souling it out, not rocking it out.
Well, they're gonna know where it came from.
Me,
I think
we also want people
to have a good time. So,
yeah.
Okay, CeCe, go ahead, CeCe. I'm sorry. Everybody was started talking at the same time.
Oh, I'm sorry, man. Okay.
That's okay.
It was I did a collaboration with Mother Save Your Child, and he did a song for me called Wish, and another song called Purple Funk, which was a song that was kind of like a tribute song to like the Prince fans and people who like funk, you know. And so I'll be doing Sonny. So that's what's different. I'm performing those out in public, and I haven't had a chance to do that yet. So that's what makes it so phenomenal.
Wow. So Jessica did all of this. She brought all of this fire, all of this talent together in one place.
Okay. Man, I love her. I just wanted to let you know I love her. I can't hear everybody else if they're talking, but I just want to say I love her, and I can't wait to see y'all tomorrow. And I'm running, so I wanted to make sure I called in and said I loved everybody, and I'm looking forward to it. And I'll see y'all in the deep.
All right.
Bye,
thank you so
much.
Thanks for having me, y'all.
Thank you. Okay.
Right.
So, you guys, I'm so proud. I'm so proud. I'm proud. You know, I've already been proud walking around with this S on my chest, or B on my chest, because I've been walking around proud to be Black. You know, it started with, you know, Wakanda, and then
the
I'm
Black
going around,
Panther.
You know,
yes,
the Black Panther.
The Black
Wakanda. Wakanda for life. And then it went on to A Wrinkle in Time, because I saw A Wrinkle in Time a few times this past weekend, and it is absolutely amazing. It really, truly has a message. And then now I have my Black Women Rock. Yeah. And you guys are rocking it out and so doing what you do so unapologetically, but owning it. It's just a great thing and a great way to feel. And I'm so glad that you guys are showing the world that it's okay. And I guess the reason why I feel this way is because we haven't seen it a lot for us as African Americans to be okay and to love who we are.
And I want to say something I think that is bigger than that. Not bigger than that, I think, is this idea that Jessica is making room or providing an example to make room for others.
Yes.
Where room needs to be made.
Yeah.
And I think that all of us should practice that.
Yeah.
Because I think for so long, and unfortunately, especially in Detroit, it's very crabs in a barrel. And it's very like, oh, this is mine. And
yes.
I can't, you know what I mean? And
yes.
I hate that. I feel like... This is what it's about, and this is how we accelerate. And we don't need, and you know, big ups to everybody who's in a sorority, but we shouldn't have to be in a sorority in order to provide and create networking opportunities and business opportunities in order to build bridges, because when our clique is tight, that is how we really support women, and that's how our dollar circulates.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Like, and that's what it needs to be about. We need that. circulation.
I mean, we did it this for 2 weeks in a row and made the top first and second box office people African American color.
Right.
If we can do that collectively as a world, we can continue to do that.
Absolutely.
It's just a mindset shift. We got to shift our thinking in a way we're thinking of. Love one another. Love. Any last words, you guys? I'm so sorry. Oh my God, I didn't know. I can get all you guys on at the same time. It's going to be more parties because this is not the first time I want you guys on here. Any last words, Sate or Sylvia?
I'm just looking forward to this. I can't wait to meet everybody.
Man.
Me too. I know I've done Black Women Rock before, and it was a family affair. We all became sisters right away, so I'm looking forward to meeting more sisters and creating, you know.
The family is about to grow.
Yes. Idea, Mahogany, last words.
Black Women Rock.
2018 and forever.
All right. I thank everyone. Sabrina A. Smith, Tara Carissa, Jessica Caremore, Cece Penison, Sate, Sylvia, Gabby. I don't know where you were, but Gabby is a guitarist. You're going to see her this weekend. Shout out to her. She's going to lay it out. Idea, Mahogany Jones. I
don't
just really think. And Nona
Hendrix.
I think each and every one of you women for being unapologetically who you are, because it helps me be unapologetically who I am so I can help somebody else. You've been listening to On the Go with Tiffany Patton. Your link to love, life, and liberty. May your weekend be blessed and go out this weekend and see Black Women Rock March 17th at 7 o'clock, Charles H. Wright Museum. Have a blessed weekend.